We are in our eighth year in the Weidner School of Inquiry. It's hard to believe it's been 8 years. My name is Jennifer Felke, and I am the director of the Weidner School of Inquiry here at Plymouth High School. When we started the Weidner School of Inquiry, we knew we wanted to have an emphasis on science because we know that kids build a lot of skills, problem-solving skills, analytical skills in those science classes. And we also know there are a lot of jobs connected to those science courses. I want kids to get excited about science. And I know some kids either like love science or hate science, but we try to make science fun. All our freshmen take biology, and one semester we combine that with bioart, and that's been really awesome.
I'm Haley Church. I teach drawing, painting, ceramics, and then also bioart. The first question I always get is, what is bioart? And it's a combination of biology, which freshmen have to take, and then intro to 2D art. My partner for bioart now is Miss Unsicker.
How did you do that?
This will be our second year teaching together.
Biology is my specialty. They're going to be working on building a cell membrane model. So what they're doing is using their knowledge of what's in the cell membrane, and then they use the different pieces of material that they come up with to build an actual model of the cell membrane.
We try to take the concepts in biology, and then we find a way that art can complement that.
A lot of students learn best by doing with their hands.
Our biggest project is Clay for Cancer. They make a project out of clay. They get to sell that as a silent auction. All of the money that we donate goes to the Cancer Association of Marshall County. They are pushed to present to the community.
We get tumors removed.
It's always fun to see them get dressed up and invite their parents and grandparents, and there's just a lot of people that look forward to it every year. The biology portion of it is that they learn about how cancer works. And so for bioart, they earn a total of 3 credits.
Kids who maybe aren't fans of biology find a new appreciation of it through art. And then kids who maybe consider themselves not to be the best artists learn those skills through biology. So the course integration can be really powerful. Sophomore level science course is chemistry, which is challenging in and of itself. We combine that with food chemistry.
We look at the chemical side of food, and we apply those chemistry basics to our food science lessons.
Food science, which is an agriculture course, and that is college credit. Kids can earn 3 credits at the end of the year for that.
My name is Scott Michael, and I am an agriculture educator here in the Weidner School of Inquiry.
We will pick up where we left off with the at the end of first semester, talking about John Lewis structures.
John Johnson teaches chemistry, and then I teach food science.
The way they teach, they're always helping you.
So we're paired together all day for our classes.
You do like things with chemistry, but you also incorporate that into food.
It's a blocked class.
So it's a period and a half.
And so one of our projects was an ice cream lab.
We put milk in a plastic bag, and then we add ice and salt around it to lower the freezing point of the water and the ice.
It was pretty cool. We were kind of expecting it though, based on what we were doing.
A lot of people wore gloves because it was so cold that your hands would freeze.
Underneath that ice, it's a bag inside a bag basically, and you have to shake it up.
And that causes the milk to crystallize, and we add a little bit of vanilla flavoring to, and we essentially make vanilla ice cream.
I started project-based learning when I was in sixth grade.
Oh, I transferred over in third grade.
And ever since then, I loved it.
You have more time to do projects, and you have to get up in front of people and present a lot.
I want to go to college and like study science.
I'm thinking about majoring in something like theoretical physics.
Those skills they're learning and the knowledge they're learning in chemistry, they're going to be able to take to health careers. Everything's interconnected. And then our year 3 science in here is physics and ag, tech, and power, and that is another course integration that is very hands-on.
John Johnson is the physics teacher, and I am the ag, power, structure, technology teacher.
They're both very helpful and very good teachers.
If students are in the traditional side of the high school and they want to experience a project-based class, they can do that. Any student can come in and take our physics.
I'm Mary-Kate Flynn. I'm a senior at Plymouth High School. I am on the traditional side of the high school, but I do participate in some WSOI classes like the physics and ag dual credit class. We break it up between like the physics part, so the math concepts and the different things to be applied like momentum, and then we go down to the ag shop and like work on how to apply those skills within ag power.
And they build a trebuchet, which is kind of like a catapult.
And we researched the trebuchet, which was like used in like a long time ago to like launch like dead things or like things at castles.
And they launch a golf ball, and then they have to calculate all the physics, the projectile motion physics with that.
And you want to find the exact angle so when it releases, you get the optimal distance that you'd want.
And then on the ag power side, we're looking at shop safety, woodworking, fastening, the different type of joints that they make in those woodworking projects.
We would do a couple test runs, see how it flung, see the distance, and catapult or calculate exactly what angle we needed to figure out how far it could go.
That always is a nice light bulb moment when you can see them start to connect the dots.
I started with the project-based learning back in fifth grade. It kind of gives you that real life experience of collaboration with each other and being able to work with people that you may not necessarily talk to on a daily basis, but you have to get along with to make this project work.
It's definitely cool to be able to touch things and like learn at self-pace. Like sometimes it's nice to have instruction, but it is nice to be able to learn at your own pace and like apply these concepts.
So a lot of the skills they're learning in physics, they're going to be able to take to welding. If they want to do welding, they can take it to precision machining. We're just really proud of the fact that we do encourage so many science courses, and the course integrations allows kids to complete projects and learn those other important workforce skills like collaboration, critical thinking, problem solving, and it really helps prepare them not only for college but also going into work.
It's really fun to see them grow and build some confidence.
Well, we try to make those lessons so that the students are seeing real life examples and that they can look at and see and touch and feel, and then they can go out and use in the real world.